In this video, we're checking out an old school drag car that's sitting 6 miles from my house, and I had no idea that this thing even existed. So let's go check it out. You're probably going to have to talk me out of buying this thing because it's dirt cheap and I just got to have it. So local drag racer Jim Montgomery told me about this car. He said it was rough, but it was also cheap. So I wanted to look at it. It was a Chevrolet Monza. Now, these were pretty popular drag cars back in the 80s. And you can see that this thing is pretty rough. There's not much left of it just from a first glance. As we make our way around, we can see that it's got fiberglass doors on it. The fiberglass front end is sitting over here by itself. We can see that the car was red in a previous life. It's got primer and stuff on it now, but you can still see that red on there. And you can see a little bit of remnants of some of the decals and lettering and stuff that was on it. And the biggest clue right here on this window, it says Robert Ladd. Now, I had heard of that name before. I didn't know much about him or anything like that. That's something I'll research in the future. But for now, we're just kind of checking this thing out, seeing if it's something that I want to try to buy or piece back together or, you know, do my normal thing as far as research and all that. So as we look here, the front suspension is all gone. But you can see that, you know, it probably had some sort of tubular control arms on it. The front frame rails look like they're in pretty good shape. I don't think this car was crashed or anything like that. Everything appears to be pretty good, but it was disassembled. So there's a lot of missing pieces. We can see the Lexan windows are pretty much fogged over. You can't see in or out of them. And one thing I did notice here on the windshield is that it's got a 5-point blank, and that would have been his dial-in for back in the day. And I'm just saying, back in the 80s, if you had a door slammer that was running down in the fives, that was a pretty strong run car. And just judging by some of the details I'm seeing so far, this car was very light. The door is off of it, but you can see that it didn't even have a latch or a hinge on this side. So he was trying to save weight everywhere he could. The door is just laying in there, but you can see that it was held on in place with Zeus fasteners. And you can really see how gutted this thing is. I mean, there is not much there. It's just a roof skin, quarter panel skins, which even that, the material has been taken away because they've stretched those wheel wells out. They obviously had a really big tire under the back of this thing. You know, really neat to see all these different things that he's drilled out, including the door handles. Like, that's just like an ounce. But when those ounces add up, you got a few pounds. So, you know, pretty cool to see all that. It's definitely one of those things that, you know, nowadays people, if they're wanting to save weight, they'll buy titanium stuff or they'll buy something, you know, out of a catalog. But back then, you got the drill out, you made it lighter in your own shop. And that's what I love about cars like this. Even though this isn't like the heyday of drag racing in terms of like 60s gassers and AFX cars and funny cars and things like that, these cars were still innovative. They were still home built. They were still grassroots drag cars. So it's cool to take a look at this thing, try to understand exactly, you know, what class it might have run in and get some more information on it. You know, I've got the name right there, Robert Ladd. I can start researching using that and see what I can find out. As far as the chassis is concerned, this looks like a really nice piece. I mean, it's been sitting outside for a while. I would want to check everything out for rust if I was ever going to try to put this car back together. But really, it looks very nice. The rear suspension setup looks cool. It's got an old school four link setup. It must have had some sort of coilovers on the back. You can see back here where he's got his battery mounted, or would have had the battery mounted. Everything around here is drilled. Every bracket on this car is drilled for weight savings. You know, this thing, it had a lot of cool pieces on it that were pretty much homemade. This was not something that you could just go out and buy. Even though the chassis does appear to be an aftermarket, maybe a Chris Alston or something like that. Again, I'll research more of that in the future. But this thing, this is what people did back in the day to go fast. You built big motors and you took away every ounce of weight that you could. There's no doubt about it. This old car is pretty rough, but I feel like you could patch this thing back together and make it look like something again. And that's something that, you know, I would be comfortable with. I don't know that I'd want to actually try to put the thing back together and race it, but I would like to mock it back up and, you know, stick some old wheels up under it, kind of scotch it up so it looks like a car. And I don't know. We'll see. We'll see what happens with it. It's definitely in my price range. It's in my budget for these types of old cars. You know, there's not a whole lot of money to be made on something like this. It's not something we'd flip and make a few dollars on. It's more than likely just something we would piece together and hang on to and just kind of put it out there as a yard ornament. So is it really saving it if it's just going to sit outside? I mean, we literally have 9 old drag car projects sitting in the garage. Some of them are sitting outside, and this one would just sit outside, sort of like how it's sitting right now. So leave a comment. Let me know, should I buy it? Should I walk away?